Hey everyone, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. Today we're looking at two different menu variables that allow us to determine what the user has clicked. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So let's go ahead and look at the first one of these. So this is SC menu item, and this contains the menu item by the ID. We'll look at where to get that ID that was clicked by the user. And then the next one is SC script name, and that contains the name of the application that was selected by the user. So as you can see, here's a documentation for SC menu item here. And it gives us the ID of the item that was clicked here. Here's a couple different examples here. We're going to go ahead and copy one of these here. So we can go ahead, let's copy this one here, and we're going to take this over to our Scriptcase development environment, to a menu we have set up here. So here we are, we have a menu, basic menu set up here. If we go to menu items, we can see the items that are set up on this. So if we look at this, we're going to determine when the user clicks that. So that's item underscore 2 is the ID of that. So let me copy in that code. SC menu item equals item underscore 2. So we're looking at when that is clicked. And then when that's done, we're going to redirect here. So this is using the SC reader macro. There's another video in this series about that if you haven't used this macro before. But pretty simple, we're just redirecting here to another application here. Let me tab that over. Make sure that is right. Let's make sure I spell that correctly. And then we're not going to pass through any parameters, but we do want to redirect outside of the current menu application. So we're going to redirect to the parent, since this is going to be from an iframe. So we're going to take over the screen here. Let's go ahead and load this here. And it's going to come around and load our menu application here. As you can see, there's our grid actor. We're going to load that, click on that. And then it's going to redirect us out of the menu to our grid actor, just like so. So that's how you use the SC menu item. Now let's look at the SC script name. So here's the documentation for that. And pretty simple, it's pretty much the same thing, except now we're looking at the actual script name instead of the item ID. So let's go ahead and copy that. And we're going to take it over here and we're going to put it in the same bit of code, except it's going to be a little bit different. So we're going to substitute menu item for script name, like so. And then we're going to redirect the same way, but now this is going to be our grid actor application. So it's clicking the same thing, but this time we're checking the application name, which is grid actor. Click on that, and it's going to do the same thing. It's going to redirect us out to the grid there of actor, just like we did before. So that's how you use the Scriptcase menu variables to determine what item or script name that the application, that the user clicks.